Hello and welcome. Today we're going to look into CompletePBX Dial Profiles. So let's search for Dial Profiles. We will find it here. Dial Profiles will let you create a profile that determines what caller and recipient may or may not do and some other settings, and then apply them to extensions and trunks. So let's see how it looks. First of all, you can see we have a default dial profile, and here are the settings, and I can create my own dial profile. So let's create a new dial profile and see what the options are. Let's call it extension default. Okay, because what I will allow callers from extension will probably be different from callers that arrive from trunks. Okay, the first thing is allow transfer by. So who is allowed to transfer a call? Caller, recipient, or both? So if we're calling from extension, I can let the caller transfer a call, but I don't want the recipient to transfer a call. There is a very important warning here, and it's worth reading. Enabling transfer by caller may allow an outside caller to exploit the PBX. Okay, what does it mean? If I will set this profile to trunks, it means that an outside caller may make a call and transfer the call, which means depending on how the PBX is set up, they may be able to transfer it to an external location and basically create a call at your expense. So you need to be very careful with this. Okay, so allow transfer by. Allow park by, same logic. Caller, recipient, or both. Here I will set caller. Music on hold class, if I want a special music on hold for this profile. Call screening behavior. So disabled ask once, which will basically ask the caller to identify themselves once and then use the same identification each time, or always ask. So let's leave it at disabled. Custom options, for those of you who know asterisk, these are the asterisk custom options, capital T, lowercase t, and so forth. And ringing tone, whether or not we want to sound a ringing tone to the calling party before the recipient actually generates a ringtone. Okay, so let's save this profile. It's called extension default. Okay, so now it was successfully saved and we can apply it. As I mentioned before, it may be applied to extensions or trunks. So let's just pick an extension here. Say I want Agent Smith to have this profile. So under advanced, I will find the profiles, and now I can see my default extension default profile and update it. As I said, it may also be used for trunks. So if I go to trunk, I will see it here right in the general page. I hope you found this video useful. There are many other instructional videos on our YouTube channel. Looking forward to see you there.